Hey guys, it's Hink here, and boy, do we have a spicy one today. So very controversial, the debate on ethnicity, race, and penis size, how they're linked, if they're linked at all. And also we'll discuss some of the myths like BBC and, you know, the myth that some Asians are small. So we're going to discuss all that today based on actual real scientific data and try to get an answer. So stay tuned. All right, guys, so first thing we gotta do is we have to define what is average. So it sounds stupid, but the majority of men have an average penis size, which is why you have like the average size. I know it sounds stupid, but so many men don't realize that. It wouldn't be the average if it wasn't what most guys had, basically. And I don't get pedantic in the comments talking about, well, mean versus mode. I get that. So when we look at what is the average, it's around 5.45 inches, okay, in length, or about 13.85 centimeters, and about 4.73 inches in girth, or about 12.01 centimeters. There's averages, guys. I mean, please comment for the algorithm because that's very helpful for this, but like the fact that guys get so worked up over like a tenth of an inch is still bizarre to me. So anyways, let's move on, okay? And so what is the role of race and ethnicity when it comes to penis size? Well, there's a website, it's called penissizes.org, and I'll put up a little safe for work screenshot here. I mean, it's a pretty safe for work data, but what they did is they actually looked at like over 40 different papers looking at the different race and ethnicity and how that relates to penis size, and they came up with the data. Most importantly, guys, there are flaws in all of this data. There's flaws in the sense that some of this data, they tried to limit it, but some of it is self-measurement. Some of it was stretched flaccid length. Some of it wasn't measured by a strict medical professional. So they did the best they can, but this is very good data in general, okay? So the short answer is there differences based on race? Well, I mean, yes and no, okay? So like, here's a chart where you can see the differences in sizes based on race. So you can see that there is some fluctuation. However, they're all pretty much within the standard range. And so I made videos before on standard deviation, which is basically what is the normal variance of a population or a data set and what is expected within the normal variance. And you can see that all of these measurements are all within the normal variance. So even though you have your biggest difference between happens to be Black or African American and East Asian, that difference is still within what we would say is the standard deviation range. So if you look at Calc SD, their average is about 5.5 inches, but their standard deviation is almost 0.7 inches. And so you can have a very wide range of what would still be considered a normal distribution of data. So there's not really a big difference when it comes to race. And speaking of Calc SD, they actually have different calculations. So I'll put up some kind of screenshots here, but you can see that if you put in whatever your measurement is and you looked based on if you're Middle Eastern or Eastern or Western or the global average, your percentage difference can change quite a bit. So there is some variability in sizes. When you're looking at average penis size rankings, guys, it so happens that according to this data set, which is multiple different published papers, African Americans or Black are number one, then white, then Asian Americans, and then Middle Eastern, and then Southeast Asians, and then East Asians. But once again, guys, when you look at that distribution, it's within the normal variance, even going from the largest average to the smallest average, okay? And so speaking of that standard deviation, one thing that they did make note of is that the actual standard deviation is wider in the data set when you looked at actually Black or African American people. So here is the chart looking at the white Americans. You have an average of 5.71 with a range of basically, if you include the standard deviation, between 4.76 and 6.65 with that standard deviation length of 0.9 inches, okay? Whereas with the girth, you have an average girth of 4.82, but a standard deviation of 5.1 inches, meaning the range of what would be still considered within the normal distribution. So if you look at the Black population though, you have an average of 5.57, but the standard deviation range is 1.13 inches. And so you have a much wider distribution of what's called normal. And similar thing happens in the girth perspective. You have a wider range of what's normal all the way from 4.27 to 5.26. And so even though your average is similarly, it does appear that there is at least in this data, which is limited, guys, that there does appear to be a wider range, which is part of the reason why I think that you know, potentially the BBC myth came from is that if you do have some of the guys that are on this larger side, you know, that can somehow skew the data, but that's a whole different thing because it's not just like guys having bigger penises. There's a whole racist history to that that most people don't know about, which is still perpetuated in porn. And so it's a very harmful stereotype that I really hate. Hey guys, Darth Hink here. Had to make a quick correction here. I have a fantastic editor who caught this, but on my initial video, which you just watched, you could see that I actually referenced Asian Americans. The data set for the African Americans, which he puts up in just a few minutes, and I'll have him put up a little blurb on the side here, you can see that the actual standard deviation range in length for African Americans is 3.1 centimeters, which is 1.2 inches. And so a standard range of what is normal, you can see the average already starts off higher, but if you can go up or down an entire 1.2 inches, that's still considered a normal range. And so you have a much wider normal variance. And so that might be part of the reason that that BBC myth developed, because though the average is still well within limits, you do seem to have a little bit more outliers on honestly either side. And so it's very unfortunate if you are a black guy with either an average dick or certainly a smaller than average dick. Anyways, guys, just wanted to make that correction. Back to the regular programming. Let's move on to the next topic. And so they also looked at the studies by country. And you can see that when you look at the studies of averages between Europe, USA, Mexico, all of these places where they have published data where you can actually see the range, honestly, guys, it's right around 5.5 inches. Sometimes it'll be as low as like 5.3, sometimes as high as like 5.7, but in these measured data sets, it's right around 5.5. It's all pretty much the same. Interestingly, when you look at the difference in, let's say, height, okay, measured objective data. So in India, they've been measured as the shortest at 162.2 centimeters versus in Holland, when they've been measured on average at 183.8 centimeters, the difference between those two, the shortest and the tallest, is about 13%. What they found in this data set is that that difference range actually corresponds with the difference in penis size. And so when you look at the average length difference between East Asians and blacks, the difference is about 14%. It makes sense when you have a normal distribution that can have environmental factors such as the diet. So studies have showed that when you have a higher protein diet concentration, the people grow taller. So pro tip, if any of you guys that are young parents or, you know, planning on having kids, there is a positive correlation between how much protein a kid gets and how tall they can get. Anyways, what I'm saying is that you expect to see some of the normal differences in distribution. And so once again, guys, this data is flawed. The conclusions are only as good as the data. It is extremely hard to get very accurate, scientifically measured erect penises in both length and girth. I don't know if any of you guys have tried to measure yourself, but you know, you try to get as hard as possible and then try to measure, and then by the time you get the, you know, the ruler out, you already start to lose some EQ sometimes. And so it's hard to get truly accurate data. So just take all this data with a grain of salt, guys. Well, what about that study that showed that men from the Congo have an average penis size of 7 inches in length? That study is absolute okay. The study's been criticized widely by many actual smart people and professors, PhDs, and guys, they gathered the data from self-reported sources just found on the internet. It's not reliable. And so if you actually look at that data, it showed that men from Ecuador have an average of 7 inches, Ghana 6.8, Colombian 6.7, and North Korea at 3.8. I mean, that's just not consistent at all with the actual data that is accumulated from actual measured penis size. The key points from this whole thing is that when you look at ethnicity, is like, how reliable is it for actually a group of people, like, you know, a race as a whole? It's actually fairly representative, guys. When you look at the averages, once again, on like East Asian versus, you know, the Asian Americans or whatever group it might be, you can see some differences. However, ethnicity is not an indicator of individual penis size. I can't emphasize that enough. It is not an indicator of, oh, well, every black guy is going to have a big dick and every Asian guy is going to have a small dick. No. So those myths are categorically false. You can see some averages. But once again, guys, these averages are all within the standard deviation range. Okay. And so it's all within a normal variance. So just don't get too caught up on this, that yes, there are some racial differences, but in general, they're minimal. Once again, I'm gonna put up that chart from the beginning where you can see that the difference range and the different heights of the charts, they are all very similar, guys. So speaking of getting your best measurements, guys, if you really want a good supplement that's gonna help with increasing blood flow, whether you be working out or whether you just wanna have the maximum erection quality, Vigor is available. It's by Leviathan Subs. It's available at leviathansubs.com. It's a company, it's a formula that me and BD personally made and put together. And guys, it works. It's also available on Amazon Prime. As you can see here, it's getting great reviews. So check it out if you want to support us or if you just want a good product. So to close, guys, you know, yes, there are some racial differences in general when it comes to groups, but the averages are very close to the same. So please don't get caught up with and please stop perpetuating myths like the BBC myth, guys. I hope that by learning real life averages and real life differences in actual data set, that you can actually start to get over the dysmorphia, like at least like I had, thinking every guy was huge, and especially even me, I thought every black guy was way bigger than I was until I actually learned the statistics. So guys, you know, do your own research, form your own conclusions. Hopefully this helps some of you out here. Peace and love. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.